Hello everyone, welcome back to Lynn's Homestead. After being in the heat all day, doing a lot of work, I was too tired to do anything outside. So, today we're in the kitchen. I wanted to try to make fried squash. I got some summer squash. I only had one that was ripe. When they're ripe, for me, they always seem to be big. So let's get started. Okay. We got some self-rising flour. Got some buttermilk. What we're going to add to this is some, I got some minced onion. Just kind of give it a little flavor. Not much, just a little bit. Then get some garlic powder. Add some of that. And for a little added flavor, got some panko crumbs. So we're just gonna add some of that in here. And we're gonna mix that up. I got some oil on the stove heating up. I know it's hot, I can tell by looking at it. As you see, we got it mixed up. So, next, we're going to cut this squash up. Let me turn the temperature down a little bit. On a sharp knife. And let me get my cutter. I'm just going to put that over there for now. As a kid, we didn't have squash growing up. We had all kinds of vegetables, but squash, I don't remember it being one of them. Now, many recipes that I've watched, they didn't do the bigger ones. They always had the smaller ones. Well, all my smaller squash, they're not right. I can understand they don't want all the seeds. I made a video not too long ago for a squash casserole. There's just so much prep to it. Now we're going to cut these up in just kind of like chunks here. And we're going to put them in the buttermilk. And I would have made a video on how that was made, but it was kind of like an afterthought. So let's get this stuff cut up. Kind of funny, I don't normally buy buttermilk for anything but this. Always willing to try something new. Squash has so many health benefits that I kind of wanted to get in on. That plus, you know, you spend all this money. Okay. Put this thing back. This in the sink. Try to keep everything clean. Maybe take a little bit of fire here.
Oh, yeah.
It's hot. Alright. I'm going to just kind of mix this stuff around in here. I don't know if you can see, but I want to get this well coated. The buttermilk. Pretty good. Now we'll get you over to the stove and we're going to get this cooking in oil. Now, if I've done this right, it should work pretty well. So we'll get this stuff to cook in here. I've never made this before, so I don't even know if I even have enough oil enough. If you have any comments, I'm open to suggestions if I'm doing this right or wrong. I say, I've never done this before. So, y'all tell me, does this look right? I'm thinking I almost need to put some more oil in there. Now, the casserole that I made, that looked pretty awesome. I mean, it looks, and it just, here, let me get you a little closer. I mean, it looks good. But, I don't know. I'm good at many things, but sometimes I'm at a disadvantage in the kitchen. Some say I need a good woman to tell me. Well, no, my dad always was the chef of the family. How you tell whether it's all the way cooked. And there you go. One squash, fried. It's like really hot. I'm gonna let it cool down a little bit before I eat it. I tried one, it tasted all right. The thing I'm having a problem with, it doesn't look as crispy with a decent sized coating like it showed in the instructional video. But again, this is my first time doing it. But anyways, that's it for this video. Let me know if I did something wrong, or because it seems like anytime I make something fried, I never get the coating like in a chicken. I don't know. But smash that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. It's completely free to do so. I mean, if I'm not teaching you something, at least I'm being entertaining. And leave a comment and share it with your friends. And I'll see you here next time on Lynn's Homestead. Because here, we never know what we're going to do. You have an awesome day, and God bless.